What is up, Pats Nation? It is Patriots Global here with another video, and yet again, the New England Patriots have made moves to the 53-man roster. They have signed free agent linebacker Ramon Humber. Now, if you've been a Patriots fan for a long time, you might notice that that name sounds familiar, and that is because a few years ago, he was actually on the Patriots team. He spent the offseason with them before getting cut for roster cutdowns. He was signed by the Saints and then in 2016 spent the offseason with New England, and then when he was cut by New England, he was signed with the Bills and played for them the previous 2 years. Now, if you saw my video about the Patriots bringing up Duke Dawson to the active roster finally, you know that the Patriots had released two players when they only had to release one. They released running back Kenyon Barner and linebacker Nicholas Grigsby, so they did have an open spot, and that is basically the spot they used to bring him in. Very interesting what we've seen from the Patriots from the beginning of the season to what we're seeing now. They really did try to go younger, they tried to go more athletic, and it really just wasn't working out for them. If you look at Grigsby, who they had cut, he was younger, he was more athletic than this guy, and he was faster. But the problem is that a lot of the issues the Patriots are having, especially on special teams, is coming from the fact that these are young guys who are very inexperienced in the NFL. And that is really a big reason why Bill Belichick prefers experience over athleticism and just all that younger stuff. For anyone that follows up with the New England Patriots news a lot, then you already know that he is going to be wearing number 50. Now, that was the number that Grigsby did wear, so he is taking his number. So you're going to want to look out for number 50 on the field. Now, just like Albert McClellan, I really just expect this guy to be playing special teams for the most part. I think the fact that the Patriots released Grigsby kind of shows that they are going to be using at least one of the two linebackers that they have recently signed in some type of way. I'm not expecting them to be an every down back like a Kyle Van Noy or a Dante Hightower. But I don't feel like they cut a linebacker and then sign two linebackers and then just put them on special teams. Now, I do mainly feel that this is going to be another main special team signing. I mean, if you look at how just the things that he's done with the Bills, I mean, just in the previous 2 years, he's played just 10 games, or not played, he just started 10 games for the Bills at linebacker. And that really is due to him being a core special teamer. This special teams has been one of the worst I think I have seen on a Bill Belichick coached team. And we all know how much Bill Belichick loves special teams, and the fact that they are playing like trash, you already know that he is going to be making signings, and he has already made two. I know that a lot of New England fans are probably going to really gas the heck up out of this, and I just want to tell you right now, do not expect a lot from this guy. Obviously, he can come in and he can shock everyone. He can do great. He can do better than any of us expected. But when you look at his stats, he just does not seem like the type of player that is going to come in and make a huge impact on the defense. Now, if you're wondering his age, he is 31, so he is up there in age. He is a pretty big guy, though, has a pretty dang big frame, so I expect him to be a hard hitter when he is actually playing on defense, or if he does play on defense. Now, last year, he had a career high of 89 tackles and has a career total of 222 tackles in 130 games. Now, as for his status for the Jets game, I totally expect him to be playing. I mean, we're on a bye week, so he has time to catch up and learn the playbook, but he has also been in the system before, so he kind of knows what is up. He kind of knows what's expected, so I really don't see why he would not play versus the Jets. Again, not a high-profile signing. In my opinion, this could be a guy that is a potential cut canny if it comes down to another guy that they want to sign. But of course, I'm just going off of the stats that he has brought up, and I'm just going off of what is being said about him now, and along with also how I think he is going to produce as a Patriot. But I could be totally wrong. You know, he could come in and he could literally be a new version of a James Harrison. Really doubt that, but you never know. But that is it for today's video. What are your guys' thoughts on the signing? Make sure you guys let me know in the comments below. Also, make sure you guys like and subscribe, as it helps me out very, very, very much. Make sure you guys share this video with everybody who knows we can go to the Patriots Global family. And other than that, I will catch you guys in another video.